Day.
I will not forget that at all. I will not forget that at all. I get an extra hour of sleep. Don't forget to check your smoke detectors. But we do have to get through tomorrow first, because a lot of parents are a little anxious about tomorrow.
I can imagine.
And if we could just go over things one more time, because a lot of times people only think they're only hearing snow.
Well, that's true.
If they're like me, they panic, or they see that snowflake on their phone and then they panic. So, okay, what are the chances for snow tomorrow?
Morning are pretty good.
Okay.
In the morning.
Hey, I'm like that, but I'm just trying to be calm.
The morning, it would be mixed with rain. It would be slushy snow. It's not going to stick appreciably in St. Louis, and I don't expect there to be any issues. The more important part of the day is the evening when the kids are going trick-or-treating.
I just love this animation, by the way. I love it. They are grooming with the monster mash for sure.
I think it's going to be cold.
Okay.
But there's one layer you can leave off tomorrow that we were concerned about, and that is the rain stuff.
You
won't need umbrellas. You won't need the rain slicker or the ponchos or anything else to, or the plastic bags. Which, you know, the hefty bag comes in handy.
That awesome costume that you have on.
So now you have to think about how to stay warm underneath all of that.
Okay. All right. So I have to ask you, as a dad, did your kid go trick-or-treating when they were little?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So, and St. Louis, I mean, it's a toss-up. We've had, you know, Halloweens where it was like in the upper 70s, and then we've had snow on the ground, and then, of course, it's just been cold and dry. So what would you recommend to parents?
For tomorrow?
For under the costume.
You know, long johns or sweats probably are good. If, depending on their age, if you have the running pants, you know, those things that, you know, the wicking stuff that allows you to breathe but not suffocate, kind of thing, that would probably work. A windbreaker of some sort or something to keep, because it's still going to be breezy tomorrow with those winds. So it's not just the cold, it is the wind, and wind chills will be as low as any point we've seen so far this season. So you just want to be aware of that. But, you know, a lot of those costumes, the girls would probably be the ones you'd be most concerned about, because they're in the dresses.
And the tutus.
And the tutus. That's going to be rough. But like Batman there, as long as he's got some, you know, black sweats on underneath his cape, he's probably all right.
All right, so we just saw a teen, which, more power to you, girl. Go ahead and get that candy as long as you can. What do you recommend the parents wear if they are out with their kids trick-or-treating?
Anything you want. you know, the winter coats, you know, your parkas, the winter coats, definitely the gloves.
Okay.
Make sure one hand's free with a koozie.
Long underwear.
Wear your koozie in your hand, and whatever's in your koozie, you know, is up to you. It could be a bottle of water.
As long as you're walking.
Exactly. And then pack your patients, of course. And drivers, obviously, be safe and be aware of what's going on.
All right, everybody, make sure that you go ahead and get that candy as safely as you can. Your Twitter, what is it?
Fox2CH, Fox2CH.
All right, we have your Halloween forecast here on the 9 a.m. show.